أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. We continue our theme for this Ramadan, دروس الحياة من قصص الأنبياء في كتاب الله. Life lessons from the stories of prophets in the Quran, events and incidents in and around the lives of the prophets, peace be upon all of them, which have been extracted from the glorious Quran. A noble lady, in fact, a queen, and her maids were at the Nile River, and to their amazement, they found a basket floating in the river. The queen immediately ordered her, those who were with her, accompanying her, to bring the crate-like basket on shore. And they thought, the maids thought there were some treasure in there. Instead, they found a baby boy. The queen instantly felt motherly love for the baby and reported her finding to her husband, who was the king, of course. And Allah documents that incident in the Holy Quran. وَقَالَتِ امْرَأَةُ فِرْعَوْنُ قُرَّةُ عَيْنٍ لِي وَلَكَ لَا تَقْتُلُوهُ عَسَىٰ أَن يَنْفَعَنَا أَوْ نَتَّخِذَهُ وَلَدًا وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. The wife of the Pharaoh said, "He is a joy for the eye, for me and for you. Do not kill him. It may be that he will be of benefit to us, or we may take him as a son." And they perceived not really what they were doing. The name of the lady was Asiyah binti Muzahim, described in the Quran as Imra'at Fir'aun, the wife of the Pharaoh. That Pharaoh who reigned during the time of Musa alayhi salam, and of course, the baby who happened to be in the basket was Musa alayhi salam himself. That Fir'aun who is the symbol and the epitome of arrogance, of corruption, of brutality, the arch oppressor among unjust rulers. Asiyah binti Muzahim, on the other hand, is believed to have come also from a rich family, a noble family. Very beautiful, they say, and a generous woman. And the historians say, وَالْأَرْجَحْ أَنَّهَا هِيَ الَّتِي إِسْتَقْبَلَتْ مُوسَى وَلِيدًا وَهِيَ الَّتِي أَشْرَفَتْ عَلَىٰ تَرْبِيَّتِهِ ثُمَّ هِيَ الَّتِي آمَنَتْ بِي حِينَ بَعْثُ. She is the one who received Musa and welcomed him when he was a baby. She was honored with bringing him up and training him. And when he proclaimed the message and the mission of his prophethood, she believed in him. When she witnessed how people were being tortured, including women who believed, when Musa alayhi salam and Harun, who were together at that time in the mission, under her husband's torture, she declared her faith in the presence of the Fir'aun. He tried to convince her, tried to turn her away from the faith, but Asiyah refused, realizing that faith was far more important than luxury and privilege. And therefore, the last ayah we heard tonight, Surah Tahreem, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا امْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنَ إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِهِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. And Allah sets for us her life as an example, as a parable to those who have faith. Through the wife of the Pharaoh, behold, she said, "O Allah, build for me nearness to thee in paradise and save me from Fir'aun and his doings, and save me from all the oppressors." How great a person is Asiyah. An example for every human being. Rich, beautiful lady, married to the most powerful man on earth at that time. Of all the powerful men mentioned in the Quran, none is mentioned in the Quran more powerful than Fir'aun as a pharaoh. A pharaoh who killed baby boys, and Musa alayhi salam was destined to have been killed if she didn't offer her love and compassion. She brought him out in that very house of that Fir'aun. She brought him up. And who was bringing up? not only a prophet, an ulul azm, among the major prophets, the arch prophets, the senior most prophets, the most mentioned prophet in the Quran, Musa alayhi salam, the prophet who would grow up in that very palace and eventually challenge that very tyrannical Pharaoh. Asiyah accepts the message of Musa when he receives revelation. Ibn Hajr al-Asqalani, in his Fathul Bari, Sharh al-Bukhari, he writes, he said, وَمِنْ فَضَائِلِ آسَىٰ إِمْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنِ إِنَّهَا اِخْتَارُ الْقَتْلُ عَلَى الْمُلْكِ. She chose rather to be killed than to have a kingdom. وَالْعَذَابِ فِي الدُّنْيَا عَلَى النَّعِيمِ. And she preferred rather to go through difficulty than all the privileges. الَّذِي كَانَتْ فِيهِ وَكَانَتْ فِي رَاسَتُهَا فِي مُوسَىٰ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ صَادِقَةً حِينَ قَالَتْ هِيَ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِ لِي. She, not only that, went through torture, and her insight concerning Musa was absolutely correct. Indeed, he was a comfort to her eye. There's so many lessons we can learn. Asiyah was a woman of compassion. And we learn that people who are compassionate always care genuinely about others. Asiyah was a lady of principle, married to the most powerful man with all the privileges. And we learn that principled people must have tremendous courage, a nobility of spirit, and an unwavering commitment. She died while being tortured for her belief by her husband, who had discovered that she had taken to Tawheed, and he brutally and mercilessly retaliated to her rebellion against her opposition to his tyranny. Asiyah was selfless. What did she have to gain? What did she gain in that regard in the world? And we learn how selflessness led her to abide by the truth at all cost. Asiyah was a nurturer of Musa alayhi salam, a believer in his message, his supporter, his protector, and she died a martyr. She was thus exalted among the women of all time. She was at least a believer in this world and surely a key queen in the hereafter, in a hadith documented by At-Tirmidhi, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حَسْبُكَ مِن نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ. In another version of hadith, أَفْضَلُ نِسَاءِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ مَرْيَمَ بِنْتَ عِمْرَانِ وَخَدِيجَ بِنْتِ خُوَيْلِدْ وَفَاطِمَ بِنْتِ مُحَمَّدْ وَآسِيَ بِنْتِ مُزَاحٍ إِمْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنِ. Rasulullah said, sufficient is it an example for all the people of the women of the world, the leaders of the women of paradise. Mary, the mother of Jesus, Maryam, the mother of Isa alayhi salam, Khadija, the daughter of Khuwaylid, Fatima, the daughter of Muhammad, and Asiya, the wife of the Pharaoh. May Allah grant her the highest in paradise. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.